दिस इज फ्रॉम एस के गर्ग प्रभु. ही आस्क हरे कृष्णा गुरु जी. थैंक यू गुरु जी फॉर भगवद गीता लेक्चर्स एंड मेकिंग अस टू अंडरस्टैंड इट्स मीनिंग. एज वी आर बॉर्न विथ सम मोड ऑफ नेचर, लाइक आर वी बॉर्न विथ सम मोड ऑफ नेचर और डू वी डेवलप इट एज वी ग्रो इन द लाइफ. इन दिस दुखालय इज गाइडेड बाई थ्री मोड्स ऑफ नेचर. कैन वी कंट्रोल एंड चेंज दैम? डज इट कैरी फॉरवर्ड इन नेक्स्ट लाइफ? Thank you.
Yes, but we are born. We are born with the modes of nature. In fact, our particular type of body itself is created only by the three modes of nature only. Based on the modes of nature only, we are getting our body. Sattvam rajas tama iti gunaha prakriti sambhavagam nibandhanandi mahabahu dege deginam avyam. So these three modes of material nature, sattva, raja and tama, the mode of goodness, passion and ignorance, they bind the soul inside this body. That's why nibandhanandi mahabahu dege deginam avyam. And during our life with experiences, all those things with our association and other things, our modes of nature can change also to a certain extent. So that's why we need to free ourselves from this swabhava. That is the main goal. Our goal is to not get affected by the modes of nature at all. We need to free ourselves from the three modes of material nature. But we come with the modes of nature, our swabhava, and during our life, it may be changing a little bit, but we again die with the modes of nature. But that swabhava is, for each individual, it is there. It won't change that much. So this swabhava, we have to free ourselves from this swabhava. So that means we just have to understand what is our swabhava, what is our swadharma. Then we have to perform our swakarma. So then if you do all those things as an offering unto Krishna, so then we will be freed from the reactions, free from the results of our activities. So that way we can actually slowly, we can transcend the modes of nature. And once we start serving Krishna, once you are always engaged in the service of Krishna, so that means you are not controlled by the modes of nature. So that is the best way to free ourselves from the three modes of material nature. Otherwise, they are always controlling us. When we are connected, attached to the material sense objects, we are controlled by the modes of nature. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Guruji. SK Garg, you can ask any follow-up question.
Thank you, Guruji.
Thank you, Prabhu. You understood, Prabhu? Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
I understood, Guruji. But I would like to know if the chanting will help us in getting us free from the modes of the nature.
Definitely, definitely chanting. That's what, when we connect, chanting is the process. You are remembering Krishna, you are connecting with Krishna. At that point of time, when you are chanting, when our mind is connected, focused on Krishna, you are not controlled by any mode of nature. You are already free during the time of chanting. For example, right now, we are studying Bhagavad Gita. So right now, we are not thinking about anything other than Bhagavad Gita, other than Krishna. At this point of time, we are not controlled by the modes of nature. So we are freed, actually. That's why every day, at least this time, we are studying Bhagavad Gita. We are freed from the three modes of material nature. So this is a great time for us to free ourselves from the modes of nature, actually. We are not thinking about any material sense objects at this point of time. At this point of time, when we are studying Bhagavad Gita, remembering Krishna, focusing on Bhagavad Gita all the time, so we are totally freed from the modes of nature. But this should continue 24/7. All the time, we need to work for Krishna, remember Krishna, do everything for Krishna, plan for Krishna. Do all the time, if we keep ourselves engaged in Krishna consciousness, then we are completely freed from the modes of nature. Do you understand that, no?
Thank you, Guruji. I got the answer. Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.